Hi guys. So I have tried this 3 times now, and every time that I got going, I realized that I was just rambling. Like I was saying things of no significance whatsoever. And when I looked at the astrology, the moon is void in Cancer, and that's my midheaven, and my Mars is there. So my natal Mars is conjunct with the moon that is void right now. So I was like, why can I not pull a thought together? I cannot pull anything together right now. So yeah, I've done this 3 times now. This is my third time's a charm. But I thought I'd share that like funny little tidbit of a story. So welcome to Libra season. Today is the fall equinox, spring for those who are in Australia. But the equinox is where we have equal day and night balanced out. It is also the first day of Libra season. And Libra is not just about balance, right? It's not just about justice. It's not, it, it's she, Libra is ruled by Venus. So it's also about beauty. It's also about feeling really good. It's also about yourself and taking care of yourself. And so one of the things that we are going to be doing that I'm offering this Libra season, like the meditation we had last night was amazing. They have been really, we've done two so far. Both of them have turned out extremely powerful, really, really wonderful meditations. The next two that I'm offering sort of go hand in hand with each other, but you can do them separately, or you do one and not the other, or both of them, or whatever you want to do. You can choose yourself. But the next two that I'm offering, we have the Libra New Moon on Saturday, September 28th, which is this coming Saturday. And that's actually going to be, we're going to do the Libra New Moon ritual together. And this new moon is really going to be powerful and may even feel like a full moon for some of you because it's going to be a super moon, which means it's closer to Earth. And the Virgo new moon was also a super moon. But this one is going to stem around relationships. So what during the ritual, what we're going to do is do the healing Reiki and meditation through the ritual. See where I'm going with this? And we're going to release the negative energies of past relationships that we're holding on to. And then we are going to manifest new positive and like attracting new positive relationships into our life. The following week on October 6th, and both of this is on my website. If you look at the description box below, there is like a link that will link you directly to both of these. But on October 6th, we're going to do a self-love, self-forgiveness, self-empowerment meditation and Reiki healing circle. And that is really going to help with the manifestation of new positive relationships into your life. So, wanted to get that out of the way. I know that that was a long, but right now is really the time to, we're in harvest season. And I know I told you I was going to do story time for you guys. We're going to talk about the Greek mythology behind the seasonal changes. And this Greek mythology has to do with Persephone and Demeter and the Lord of the underworld, Hades. So Demeter is Persephone's mother. Demeter is the goddess of the harvest. She is the one that makes sure that everybody is going to be fed, right? She's very Virgo-esque energy, right? And Persephone is her daughter. And one day, Persephone was out in the land and doing, the harvest and doing what she needed to do and all of that stuff. And after Hades had been shot with Cupid's bow, Cupid's arrow, who is actually, Cupid is actually Eros, the god of love, right? So Cupid shoots Hades in the butt with the arrow. That's the way that I imagined it happened, was right in the butt. I don't know why. But so, and that myth, the mythology of Eros or Cupid's arrow is when you get hit by Cupid's arrow, the first person or the first god that you see or goddess that you see, you fall madly in love with. And that happened with Hades, and Hades sees Persephone. So Persephone is out doing her thing one day out in the fields, and Hades opens up the underworld, comes up with his chariot, grabs Persephone and brings her down to the underworld. And she is now never to be seen again. Not never to be seen again. Anyways, so when Demeter finds out, and there were like nymphs and stuff with Persephone while she was out and this was all happening, so they saw, but they were so scared of what happened, the nymphs like ran away. So Demeter gets really angry and she puts everything starts to die. Like all of the plants start to die because Demeter not only does the harvest, but she also plants everything in the springtime. She's Mother Earth. Well, she's not Mother Earth, but she works with Mother Earth where she plants things in the springtime. And I know some of you are going to like correct me on some of my details. I'm not like a professional Greek philosopher or whatever, right? So please forgive me if there are some of these details that are wrong. So anyways, Demeter gets really angry. She freezes everything. All the gods are complaining. They go to Zeus that is the lord or the god over everything. So everybody's complaining to Zeus. Zeus goes to Demeter and says, could you just unfreeze things? Could you really, where everybody's like starving, we're all very hungry, we need to eat. And Demeter refuses to because nobody is helping her find Persephone, okay? And she's been looking everywhere. So finally, Zeus finds one of the nymphs that was with Persephone when Hades came up and stole her and brought her down into the underworld. And Zeus says, the nymph tells Zeus, so Zeus goes down to the underworld to confront Hades. And Hades says, okay, fine, I'll let her go. Just let me have one more night with her. Just one more night, and then I'll let her go. Okay? So, and actually it wasn't Zeus that went down. It was Hermes, which is the messenger of the gods, Mercury, right? The messenger of the gods, Hermes. So Zeus had sent Hermes down, and Hermes knew that he couldn't really argue with Hades, but Hades knew, oh man, this is Zeus. I really got to listen to what he's saying. He's my big brother. And so Hermes tells Hades, okay, just one more night, probably won't hurt. And then Hermes goes back up to Zeus and tells him what happens. And that night, Hades brings Persephone pomegranate seeds, 6 of them. And she's sad and sullen and starving. And so he gives her these seeds and she eats the 6 seeds. And anybody who's anybody knows that when you eat something in the underworld, you have to stay in the underworld. So Zeus goes back to Hades the next day and says it's time for Persephone to come up. He finds out that Persephone ate those 6 seeds. And that's where we get the 6 months at a time, where for 6 months it's very, very cold and everything dies. And Hades said she has to stay here for 6 months out of the year in the underworld, and then she can go back up to her mother the other 6 months out of the year. So the 6 months out of the year where we plant the seeds and everything blooms and everything comes into fruition, Persephone was allowed back above the underworld, back up on the earth. And for the other 6 months, the thing about it is, though, is the catch here is Persephone did not dislike being in Hades. In the underworld with Hades. She actually was one of his wives. And because when the 6 months that she was down in the underworld with Hades, she was treated like a queen. She got everything she wanted. And Hades was madly in love with her and always took really good care of her. So for this, that's the thing, is Demeter saw it one way where she was just heartbroken because her daughter was taken from her. And so she kills everything for 6 months. But on the other end, Persephone was fine. So it's very interesting, like, concept to really think about. But that is the shortened version of the Greek mythology of where the seasons come from, where the equinoxes are. So the spring equinox is when Persephone comes up, back up to the earth with, to be with her mom, Demeter, and they frolic for 6 months and have a gay old time. And then when fall hits, right, the fall equinox, and everything dies off, Persephone has to go back down into the underworld, and Demeter gets very sad and kills everything because she is in charge. You see? So that's story time with Betsy. If you guys did not, that's my favorite Greek mythology story. I don't know why it's my favorite, but out of all of them, that's the one that I always go back to. And I think a lot of it is because Demeter represents like the season that I was born in. Virgo, Libra, you know, I'm a Libra rising, and I'm a Sagittarius. So like for the first half of the fall, I'm a Sagittarius moon. Sorry, not a Sagittarius sun. I'm a Sagittarius moon. So like my major big three energies that I like that make up my personality are all in this time frame and all in the fall of when this Greek mythology story takes place. So I think that's why I love it and I relate to it so much. So the energies that we're actually dealing with, and I'll start shuffling while we talk about the energies from the sky. So I hope everybody liked that. Let me know if you liked that. Love readings. I'm going to be finishing the love readings today. I have three left to do. I'm not even going to tell you why I wasn't able to finish them this weekend because that was my plan, but I'm not going to because that's it's like a bitchy thing. Like I don't feel like bitching today because it's such a beautiful, beautiful day today. But yes, I'll be finishing the love readings. I'm starting the general readings this week. And, if you haven't seen the love readings, there is a love reading for all signs except for Gemini, Cancer, and Leo, which are going to be finished today. So go check those out. They do have extendeds. But I'm doing them differently where I'm actually looking at, because it used to be that I just look at the other person's energy. And now I'm looking at the sign's energy first. Like, so you watch your own sign. And you can do your sun, moon, and rising. Anyway, it's just, you know, a little extra that I like to give you guys. They do have extendeds, but yeah. Whoa, man. Whew. So very interesting how we're coming out of an energy. We're still kind of sitting in it, but we're moving away from it. It's like we're right in the middle of this energy still of overconfidence, over illusions, over abundance of things that it's like you're overextending yourself because you feel really, really good and you just want to like put it all out there, right? This Jupiter square Neptune and the Mercury sextile Neptune is bringing a lot of optimism right now and a lot of lightness. But the thing is with this optimism and lightness, you have to make sure that you're staying in reality because it's all with Jupiter and with Neptune. And Neptune is very illusory. Neptune shows the illusion side of things. And I'm like, what the hell am I trying to say? And Jupiter is optimistic and overabundant anyway. So we get these energies together and you can be really super over optimistic and really super over extending of yourself and it can backfire. And the reason why I'm saying that, by the way, I'm using the Fate Shifter tarot today. I told you I'm all over the place. This Mercury sextile Jupiter stuff, woo. I feel like I need to take a deep breath. Okay. So overabundance, being over-optimistic, being overextending yourself. This is why I was going to say that it could really backfire on you. There's something that's happening with someone out there Where the everything that was unstable, everything that they've been fighting for and unstable is kind of coming to a climax or falling apart. So, and then we have the Queen of Cups and we have the Nine of Wands. It's like somebody's been fighting and fighting and fighting and fighting and fighting and trying to get to a particular goal, if you will. Oh, it's all for growth and healing. Wow. Okay. So we have the three cards at the bottom. We have the Empress and the Sun and the Hermit. Okay, so somebody, and I feel like this is a person that's extremely intuitive. Everything that you've been fighting for and everything that you thought was what it was that you were supposed to have in your life is sort of just being taken away. And it's not to make you miserable. Like, it's not being taken away because God just wants to smite you and to be miserable. And we kind of had a reading like this. I want to say it was probably about a month ago. But you see that now. You see that this was actually for growth and healing. And you're allowing yourself to protect your energy. The Empress is creation. The Empress is the beginning. The Empress is Mother Earth, right? And then healing. So it feels very much like there are, we're stepping into our divine feminine right now, our divine feminine energy right now. And as we do that and become extremely intuitive, our egos, which is what the Tower represents. This is Pluto. This is Hades. This is what we were just talking about. So let's consider this Pluto and Hades, and this is Persephone. The Empress is Persephone, right? Or the Empress is actually Demeter. And we have to realize with Demeter, you know, she let her ego get involved. Oh my, and it was actually not her ego. It was her motherly instinct where she got really super pissed off and she kills everything, like all the food and everything, right? And I feel like that ego death that we've all been going through lately, like all of us are releasing some serious ego. Like I've saw myself doing it this weekend, where I did let somebody, I allowed somebody, which basically I gave somebody permission to affect my energy, and they don't even know me. Like, it was a complete stranger, and I allowed them to affect my energy in such a way that I couldn't even finish working yesterday. Because I got really angry, and I was like, I cannot push this anger out on the signs that I haven't finished in the love readings, right? So, and that's why that meditation last night was really good for me as well, because I was able to come back. This healing that's happening is happening in silence, in some deep quietness and silence. And, you know, it's funny because the Empress represents Libra and the Hermit represents Virgo. And, you know, we just left Virgo season and hit Libra season. And right in the middle of that is the Sun. Equality, day and night. I love that the cards did it that way, came out that way. There are no accidents. So let's see the Tower. And I can tell with myself these days, like the last couple of days, getting overexcited about things and having just like what I did with the whole, like I got really, really excited about the cards and everything was coming out and like I wanted to. I feel like I don't have enough time to say things. And so I have to consciously slow myself down and say, all right, sister, slow down. It's time to just breathe and slow down. So let's see what the Tower is. Judgment. Yeah. And this sort of, it had to happen this way. It was very karmic. It was very much like, it was already written, is what I'm hearing. It was already written. So it, this is taking place, the ego death, the things falling away, everything being wiped out underneath your feet so that you can rebuild. It's all happening in the exact time that it was supposed to happen. Let's see what this Queen of Cups is. Who does the Queen of Cups represent? I feel like this is your intuition really waking up into the divine feminine energy. Oh, there we go. And the moon shows up. As I say, divine feminine energy. I flipped that over and there was the moon. And your intuition is extremely strong right now. One of the things, if you're going through an ego death, if you're going through some situations where you know that you have to look at this like your whole life, that as like, this isn't even about me. Like, this is not about me. This is about this person. This is about this. This is about a whole bunch of different people, but this is not about me. And if I keep thinking that woe is me, this is about me. Oh my God, all of it, right? Then that's when the universe is going to come in and be like, I gotta start taking things away. So you know I'm serious, because you're holding on to this life, this old life, this old existence, like it benefits you in some way, and it just simply is not benefiting you. So it's time for you to let go. You can't, and that's the thing, is like, even if you're fighting for the relationships in your life, so we have the Two of Cups on the Nine of Wands. So this could have been a relationship that had to end, a very karmic relationship that had to end, and or it ended at the full moon, or it's going to end at the new moon coming up here on Saturday. Either way, you've been fighting for something that just was not working. The Tower. Just not working. You keep fighting for it and keep fighting for it and keep fighting for it. And the more you don't see the reality of the situation, which is a lot of what Jupiter and Neptune is doing right now. Jupiter squared Neptune. We had that exact on Saturday. But it's the relationship that you had to have was for your growth. Look at that. So now we have the Queen of Pentacles on the Empress. So this was definitely for growth purposes. It was to find your stability within that feminine energy. Because we've had the King of Cups showing up quite a bit, right? So we've all been sitting in our very emotional masculine energy. And now it's time for us to really get tap into the divine feminine and start to really grow and prosper from there, from creation itself. And in order for you to stay grounded during this time, sticking your feet in the dirt barefoot is the best way to get grounded, 100% the best way to get grounded. Let's see, the Sun, and some of us are not seeing the healing that is happening. Some of us are not seeing the clarity of it. Oof, okay. Eight of Swords on the Sun. That's what I mean. Some of us are so stuck in our minds that we can't even see how this is all going to come together and be healing for us. And then we have the Eight of Wands on the Hermit and the Eight of Cups, ooh, with the Lovers underneath. There, okay, so here's the thing is, I'm not saying that every relationship that of every person that's watching is going to fall apart. I'm not saying that. Like, let's not take this so literal. There could be some relationships that are not working, and it's time to move on. And as soon as you realize and recognize that you are the only person that's holding you back, or you're and that you're even holding the other person back, as soon as you realize that, that's when the energy shifts and everything starts moving really, really fast. That's for some people, right? For some of us, we have to walk away from a relationship. For some of us, there are only aspects of the relationship that we have to walk away from. And this could have to do with a water sign and an earth sign. This could also have to do with friendships, right? Family. Some of this is that the relationships that we currently are in are either on unsteady ground, and they just need to be righted. They're not toxic. They just need to come back together, right? It's a little rocky, but they're not toxic relationships. Some people, and I feel like that's why the Eight of Swords down here is kind of like, some of you aren't seeing that there are things in this relationship that need to be healed. And if we don't heal these things in the relationship, then it can become toxic, right? So I don't want everybody to think that, like, oh my God, we're all losing our relationship. That's not what I'm saying. What I'm saying is some of us are in toxic relationships, which is what the tower was showing, and we need to walk away from them because we have that connection with them. We have a really hard time walking away, right? Some of us, and I did that connection because it's like everybody thinks that just because they have a connection with somebody that that's like their true love forever and ever, amen. And that's not necessarily true. Just because you have a connection with someone does not mean that they are automatically good for you, okay? However, some of us just have relationships that we're fighting for and that we're tired of, like, arguing all the time, or we're tired of, like, we know that we're not toxic to each other, but we also know that it's not where it could be or where it should be. And there might be some emotional, like, it's time for us to open up, right? You've been the hermit long enough. You've done your studies, you've done your journey, you've been on your way long enough. Now it's time to open up to the energy and push it forward, okay? If all of you could remember to hit the like button for me, that would be really fantastic. Got to get back into YouTube's algorithm. And I'm like trying to do some different things to be able to do that. But for some reason, like a lot of my old videos are popping up on people's recommended, but none of the new ones. So if you could just like hit that like button, for me, if you enjoyed the reading and the little story time. And again, I will be starting the general readings this week. I have 1 week left open for the 20% off. Once this 20% off is done, for personal readings, I'm going to take a little break on doing personal readings. I don't know for how long, but I have a lot of things coming up where I want to do more classes and webinars and the Reiki meditation stuff. So I might open up personal readings here and there, but if you want to get a reading from me, one more week is left to order a reading from me. And then we're going to shut the schedule down for an unknown amount of time. We'll see. But in saying that, we also have the self, alignment workshop, live workshop with me on October 5th. That information is in the description box, or you can just go to my website. It's on the front page, on the very top of the page. You can see live spiritual empowerment, self-alignment, mastering yourself workshop there. And somebody asked me if I'm going to do more than one. Yes, I'm going to do more than one of those workshops. I just haven't decided the dates yet, but they will be in October and November. So And I'm also going to hopefully in the next month start doing the year end or like 2020 readings. Oh my gosh. Anyway. All right, you guys. Have a wonderful day. Thanks for listening to my story time. And again, hit the like button if you really love this and share. Share my daily readings. I want to reach as many people as I can. I love you guys. Have a great day. Bye.